Yeah, you know, action learning's been around for about 50 years now in that name, and people have done that incredibly well, and here at Duke CE we're absolutely no exception. I believe we've done some very powerful projects over the last 10 years or so. But as we sit here in a tobacco building, I have to offer some health warnings with regard to this. It can achieve results, of that there is no doubt. But for the typical executive sponsor, there are some things to be aware of. Let me start with the company, and there are two things it's really key to understand. The first, the project has to matter and has to make a difference. Individuals who participate in this are typically of high potential, and they understand the tournament nature of career in many organisations. Therefore, the issue at hand that they are being challenged to resolve has to have had some relevance in the past, will probably have some relevance now, and must most certainly have some relevance in the future. I think the second piece I'd urge executives to be aware of is that they feel confident in the process, and in so doing, feel confident in the executive education partner, whether that's Duke Corporate Education or any other. They have to have that degree of belief that this will work, for reasons I'll come to in the second area, which is the personal set of factors. I think firstly, most people get to that senior executive role by being a very powerful bundle of focused energy. And there is no doubt they will bring that energy to the project that makes a difference. However, the question is, can they sustain that energy over the project life, which will be weeks and more typically months, when many other things have been intervening, or indeed, when the project outcomes may not always be going the way they desire or anticipate. The second personal piece of advice I'd offer those same executives is the ability to suspend judgment. Typically, the individuals working on the project will be taking on a task that is two levels above their normal job. They'll be stretching their heads around a new issue that the executive will have had months or even years to wrestle with, and by their very nature, they're important and often intractable issues. The ability to not jump in there and say, haha, I know the answer to that one. Indeed, occasionally, the ability to spend not only judgment, but disbelief is really important. Okay, so let me give the last piece of personal advice, and that regards the title of this whole session, Action Learning. You know, there is an executive temptation toward action, often at the expense of learning. I hear two things. Will these people fix it now, and can they keep it simple? Those are both admirable prayers, but most intractable organisation issues are seldom simple, and they are seldom capable of instant solution without consequences. So I ask executives not only to focus on the action, but to focus on the learning. And therefore I encourage the executive, even when the project may not ultimately deliver, to keep supporting that introspective learning process so that if individuals do figure out what not to do, such that next time they will really know what to do.